coming from a sport mad, rugby mad family, we were always, you know, busy either playing in the street or at the school. There wasn't much space. And funny enough, just next to the school or at the, behind the school, there was this big rugby field that is currently still there, the Forest Street Stadium. And we weren't allowed to go play there. When I started my high school career, it was the 76 uprisings in Soweto. We heard about what happened there, about Hector Peterson that was shot, and you know, because of us wanted to show our support and solidarity towards what happened, we started at, I was at Noorderpool High School. We started throwing stones at the, all the, you know, so-called white businesses, trucks and vehicles that were passing. That same evening, they came to arrest myself and four of my fellow students who were kept in the cells and over the weekend, and we only appeared in court on the Monday. And because we were, four of us were underage, they couldn't sentence us. But our sentence was basically to be lashed, you know, with the, what do you call that, cane, with a cane, basically. And this big white policeman, you know, came in and took us out. That for me was the turning point as to why I really wanna, you know, fight this, or in those days the government, because they actually made me as a person more hard, and my whole being and my personality sort of, you know, was told at that point. It's only when I got to my final year at school, we, our family moved to Wellington, and the closest school to Wellington was Berg River High School. So I went there myself, my brother, cousins, we all went to this regular school, and somehow the teachers, the students there, they sort of heard about me being involved in Paarl, and they've asked me to come and join the student council, and that's how I got, the first time I got involved with a structured student organization. Anti-apartheid movements, and I attended meetings in Wellington, and I represented the schools in Wellington at the, you know, all the different meetings. So, while I was at college, I was selected for the Western Province colleges team, and in the South African college team that participated actually nowhere. We were just selected. We could just play against each other. Because we were colored, we weren't allowed to go play anywhere else. I also saw my own family being denied to go and represent our country. Because there was at one point my father's, two of his brothers and three cousins, there were about five of them that represented the South African so-called colored rugby team. But they were never given the opportunity to go play. So that also contributed towards my resistance basically against whatever that the government then was doing. In 1985, when I was in my final year, myself and some of the other students, we were detained by the security police. We were out in different, sometimes we didn't even know what prison we were in, because they took us in the night, the dark, in the, you know, police vans, and they just drove with us, and we didn't know where we were going. But we were mainly kept in Victor Verster and Allendale prison. The government, maybe they thought, and I mean, if you talk to other, you know, fellow students that was in prison, then it only made us stronger. It made us, you know, our whole character stronger to fight what is wrong in our community. And basically, when I was released, I didn't have an opportunity to write my final third year exams. So I had to repeat the whole year again. I had to go back to do the whole year. And I also went on to do my fourth year, majoring in physical education. We've produced, you know, very good sports people that represented our country. And I'm glad actually for that, because of the fact that in the past, because of the law and the apartheid and all that, we were not given the opportunity to represent, although we were good enough. You never got that opportunity. But as an administrator and as a coach, I had the opportunity to also, you know, represent the country internationally with the, funny enough, not rugby, or cricket that I played. It's a sport that I never really competed, you know, in a competition level, swimming. although I mean, I can swim a little bit, but I was lucky enough to represent or accompany South African schools teams on two occasions. In 96 in Australia and in 98 in China. So yeah, that is maybe my sort of reward I got from you know, giving up and not having this opportunity to go and as a player myself. I've introduced, when I started at the municipality, what we call the community games, where we go out in the community and I get young students or sport coaches and administrators to assist, to let the children in the community, give them some coaching skills and let them play games, just to keep the children busy. But for me, I would like to see this as an ongoing, sustainable program, not only once off and it's done. It needs to be, you know, something that goes on. And that will also assist with the social problems we have. Because the children, because of not being active, not having something to do, they got into, you know, all sorts of social problems they are faced with. So they need to be kept busy, and sport for me can be that tool to basically keep the children away from doing harm.